Welcome back. Today we're going to work on this part of the Brit, which is his white hair on his chest. And if you don't know who I am, I'm Peggy Kovic from Peggy Kovic's Fine Art. Welcome to my channel. Thank you. really the focus is going to be on the head, which you can't even see right now, but the focus is going to be on the head. So I'm trying to not do a lot of details down here because I don't want to detract from the head, but you still have to get it right or it doesn't look right. So you've got to get the anatomy in and kind of how the hair is flowing in the direction of the hair. And then what I do is I come in with my Mono Zero eraser and I pull out some of the hair directions. I think you can see what I'm doing. I don't know, this recording might be a worthless one. And as mentioned before, I'm not looking at the reference photo to draw the hair. I'm just doing my own thing. I know how the hair is supposed to flow. Sometimes I will take a spot on the reference photo and I'll say, hey, that looks pretty cool. And I will put it in. But other than that, I'm just doing my own thing. Because you know the hair is wavy and you know it flows around the body the way it waves. I just try to do my own thing here. Nothing special. And as mentioned, I want it kind of blurry and not really defined. So that's what I'm trying for here. And with hair, you draw it in clumps. No matter how, if you're following a reference photo or if you're just winging it, you draw the hair in clumps, no matter what. And dog hair is no different than human hair. So if you know how to do human hair, you know how to do dog hair. As you see, I'm just kind of layering. I put down some pencil, I take some pencil away. Just to put down some more pencil. And what that does is creates depth in the drawing. have a little bit of depth and details without being too detailed. Wow, I don't even know if you can see this today. I think my contrast is way off. Hmm. No. Your anatomy is basically the same, even though you can't see it. Sorry, I was talking with a eraser in my mouth. So we know the anatomy is the same. So we've got a shoulder here, we've got a shoulder here, the pecs or whatever. So probably right about here with a pec on this side. But my reference photo is not the best. That's another reason I'm winging it. Wow, I think it's done. I think I'm gonna put just a little more. Dang, I wish this wasn't so. What do you think? Too much detail? Not enough detail? I'm pretty happy with it. That is supposed to be joined, and that's not joining very nicely. It's kind of getting lost. There we go. That's better. That looks like it's part of the image. Moving some of the detail. Okay, so now we get to clean up around the edges. And then I'm going to sign it and be done with it. This is a graphite magnet. If you've never used blue tack, you need to try it. Because it just cleans up so nicely. When it stops getting sticky, then you just use it like a kneaded eraser and you knead it. And it becomes a kneaded eraser or blue tack again and picks up the graphite beautifully. There we go. Now where do I want to sign them? Ah. don't know. I'll put him away for a couple of days and come back to him.